Welcome to another Power BI dashboard tutorial. In this tutorial, we will continue our previous project, where we performed various analysis on a bank deposits database in SQL Server, creating various views using SQL queries. In this tutorial, we will use those tables and views to create Power BI report with various dashboards. So let's start our today's video. Previously, we learned to create views in SQL Server database to permanently store and reuse our queries. In today's tutorial, we will use those views and tables to create a Power BI report. To connect to our Nexus Bank database, we will copy the name of the SQL Server and use that name in Power BI to connect to the SQL Server where this database resides. In the Power BI desktop application, click on the SQL Server button, and in the SQL Server database window, enter the name of server and database. Then click on the OK button. On the next screen, enter the username and password, and click on the Connect button. Since we are using local server, we don't require username or password or encryption. Now, in the Navigator window, select all views and table you want to use in your report. All these are views, and bottom three are the tables. Now, simply click on the Load button to load these tables and views into the data pane. All data has been loaded into the data pane here. First of all, we will perform geographic analysis of deposits, therefore let's create a title for our first dashboard accordingly. To display geographic information, add a map chart to your dashboard. Now, expand the Accounts Complete table. And, add the Locality field to the Location area of the map chart. Add the Current Balance field to the Bubble size of the map chart. And rename these fields appropriately. Add the Account Category field to the Dashboard as Slicer and place it at the top right corner of the screen. Change the Slicer type to a drop-down list. Make other adjustments to the dashboard as per your liking. You may also want to add visual borders and rounded corners to your visuals for better appearance and symmetry. This dashboard is now complete. We can rename this page appropriately as well. Now, create another page for branch analysis and rename it accordingly. Add an appropriate title to this dashboard as well. First of all, add the locality field from the branches table and change the visual to a slicer. And place this visual on the left side of the dashboard. In this dashboard, we will use fields from multiple tables, which will only work if they are properly connected. Go to the model view and see if other tables are connected to the branches table properly. If database is smartly designed and column names and data types are same across the tables, Power BI will smartly connect all tables on its own. Otherwise, you will have to connect tables manually. Add the balance field from branch-wise analysis table to the dashboard as card visual and place it on the top right corner of the page. Rename the field appropriately. Make adjustments to the size of the visual, keeping in mind that three other cards will be placed here. Create a duplicate of the card visual and place it next to the existing one. Replace the balance field with the average YTD field. This field will display the year-to-date average balance in the selected branch. A very important key performance indicator. Always keep your dashboard balanced and symmetrical. Across the pages as well. Create a duplicate of a card visual and replace the existing field with the account number from new accounts table. Make sure to change it to count to show number of accounts. And rename it appropriately as well. Create another card visual to display the number of total deposit accounts. Use the total accounts field from the branch-wise analysis table. We will also display the total number of depositors on a card here. Using the total depositors field from the branch analysis table. Both fields need proper formatting, as one is without commas and the other has decimal places which are not required. We can use the table view to format the columns, and the visuals will have the same formatting. Create another card visual and add gender field from gender analysis table and depositors field as sum. Use the filter pane to display male only in this visual. Duplicate this visual, and from filters select female to display female depositors only. We must also format the depositors field in the table view to display it appropriately. You must also add the historical data to display historical performance over the years. For that, you can use the combo chart, because to display number of accounts and depositors along with balances, we must use two different axes. First of all, add the account opening date from the accounts table. Then add the current balance field from the same table to the column y-axis of the combo chart. Then add the account number field to the line y-axis as count to display number of accounts. Then add the depositors field as sum to display number of depositors. Rename the fields appropriately and adjust all visuals for better appearance. Select all visuals and add borders and rounded corners as per your liking for better appearance. Make sure the appearance of visuals is same on all pages for professional display of report. Now, duplicate one of the pages to create a dashboard for interest rate-wise bifurcation of deposits. Rename the page and title accordingly. Add a pie chart or a donuts chart to the dashboard and place it in the left side of the dashboard. Add the interest rate field to the legend and balance field to the values area of the donuts chart. Create a duplicate of this chart and replace the balance field with the accounts field to display number of accounts based on interest rates. Now select all visuals and add visual borders and rounded corners. Finally, we will create a dashboard to analyze the movement of deposits from one category to another. To display the movement of deposits among various categories during the year, we will use the movement table and the matrix visual. Add the status fields to rows and columns and the balance field to the values. Now adjust the columns of the matrix visual to fill the blank area. For further analysis, we must also use the Sankey chart, which is unfortunately not part of the Power BI default visuals. We will import this chart from file. Once it is imported successfully, we will add it to our dashboard and place it below the matrix visual. Add the current status to the source and the year opening status to the destination of the Sankey chart. Add the balance field to the weights area of the Sankey chart. Our Power BI report is now complete. The geographic analysis shows us our bank branches and deposits balance held by each branch. The branch-wise analysis of deposits display information at branch level. You can select each branch to display their relevant information in the visuals. Account category won't work because the information is taken from the branch-wise analysis table, which does not have account category. To make it work, we have to generate information from accounts complete table. On this page, you can find breakup of deposits by their interest rates. This dashboard shows the change in status of accounts during the year. You can also use the matrix visual as filter for the Sankey chart. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates. Link to the SQL Server database and Power BI file is placed in the comments below.